Hi guys, and welcome to another chat for the Femina Grazia Virtual Beauty Carnival. Today we have with us the very famous Natasha Nigamwala. Hi, thank you for doing this with us.
Thank you for having me.
Natasha, our hairstylist, director of Nalini and Yasmin Salo in Bombay, and also a Vella Passionista ambassador. So there's a lot going on there.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, so I know that there's a lot going on outside and things like this, but I think I speak for everyone when I say that we've really missed our hairdressers through the lockdown. So that makes this chat all the more exciting. Now that things are slowly opening up, how is it going now? Like, how is the salon business back in action?
Well, it's still, we're still all being very cautious. We're all one upon the directives of the government. But I mean, we do have to recognize that there is a seriousness to this situation that is going on. And in order for us to sort of nip the process or slow the rate at which it was spreading, we all as salon owners, we have to be very conscientious and we have to make very conscientious choices, which means, you know, the number of footfall, the number of staff. I mean, you know, the other day, I'm just going to make things lighter. You know, and you know how our servicing guys, you know, they come into the salon, you know, normally they would come into the salon at, you know, whatever time. People just traipse in and out. And I'm just like, talk it up, yeah, it's work. Aapko dikhna padega. I'm social distancing. And I was going ballistic with my boy, AC man, you know, I was like, servicing. Yeah. We have to be very vigilant. So, I mean, is it great that we've gotten the go-ahead to open? It is absolutely amazing.
But it comes with responsibility.
It comes with responsibility. And so we're having to adhere to the rules and the regulations, but at least we've gotten the go-ahead to get started. And that is fabulous. I can't tell you how grateful I am, to be back at work, because we were getting very like, you know.
I know. And we were feeling the same thing. So like, I remember doing a piece last year on how DIY haircuts and hair dyes were like a big rage. I mean, because honestly, we had no option. Yes. I know that all common sense dictates we do otherwise, but we had to. So tell me something, when things open up earlier or now, have you had to salvage any such messy DIY jobs? And how's that been?
You know, I mean, even for the ones that we've, you know, like a lot of us hairstylists and hairdressers across the globe, we did feel this need to step up for our clients that were getting terribly wound up and frustrated with their own hair. And so we were doing, you know, like trying to take them through that, you know, this sort of interactive where they were doing their own haircuts. And I'm swearing to you, you know, there were times when I thought I was going to give myself a heart attack, you know, where I was like, you're going wrong, you know, like I was going kind of like ballistic. And in that process, there were these, you know, I mean, of course, it was a more controlled way of doing it, but it's still, we spend years mastering our skill and our craft.
A YouTube video is not going to teach
It's not going to cut it.
I'm trying to relate. I feel.
You have you know, I mean, I have to turn and tell you that even as hairstylists, even we don't have the control cutting our own hair.
Of course.
Because how do you do, I mean, I'm just going to go into frame. If you're doing this angle on this side, how are you going to do that angle on that side? And so how do I explain this to a layperson? And then multifold, if they're doing it themselves, they're watching it, nobody's there to guide them, because they're going on YouTube. There have been disasters. I always try and find a sort of silver lining, okay, with everything. And I keep telling them, okay, you know what? Okay, so you screwed it up a little bit, but it's going to grow. At least we have that.
The only silver lining, I think, is that we've accepted to live with bad hair also sometimes.
If it is, if it's so is. Would I advise it? No. Hair grows at a very, very slow pace.
Yeah.
And so if you end up messing it up with the color or with that hair, with the haircut, you know, it's going to take, for it to grow from here to say here, it's going to take 8-10 months.
Yeah.
It's going to take 8-10 months for it to grow 4 inches.
True.
You know, I mean, think about it. So do you want to risk it? Does somebody want to risk, you know, it being...
It was our only form of adventure. Trust me.
I get that. I do get that. I'm just saying now that things, you know, just keep... Be careful. Be careful if you're going to do this, especially with the color. I am going to say this because a haircut we can correct. a color will require what we call color correction.
Yes, true.
Color correction can be harsher on the hair, harsher. Okay,
harsher
on the hair. Definitely more expensive. Definitely more time. All of those factors. And so when people are coloring their hair at home, that's something I would tell them to steer clear of. I mean, I would tell them to steer clear of the haircuts also, because it's going to take that long to grow.
Just be patient.
Be patient. Try. And I kept telling people, hey, wear a scarf. Just wear a bandana. You know what I'm saying? If you're doing a Zoom, just wear a bandana.
No, but that brings me to a very important next point, that like professional help, like you're saying, is back in the game slowly, but it's back. And like we're all craving fab hair colors, and I know I'm waiting to like book myself an appointment. So what do you think, with 6 months still to go, what's the hair color mood like for the rest of the year?
It's become, it's sort of become this culmination of balayage and weaves.
Okay.
And we've reached a point, and I think part of the reason we've reached these very, very chunky placements, and, you know, I mean, don't look at my hair, because I'm dying to, don't worry, yours is actually quite pretty, because, it's pretty hair.
Yeah,
but I've been dying to go back into the salon and do my own color, and I don't have that opportunity right now. I have to deal with my clients. That's more imperative right now. But the reason people are doing these slightly chunkier, big highlights, and, you know, this combination, what we're calling in Vella, we're calling it the illuminage, it's a combination of balayage and these slightly bigger, chunkier pieces. And the reason I believe that's become the order of the day is, one, it's faster to do in the salon. We are trying to accommodate a whole lot of clients.
Yeah, right. With least amount of exposure.
With least amount of time spent in a salon. Right. We're trying to limit the amount of time that they spend in a salon. Exactly. One, so that we can entertain more clients, but two, they don't want to spend too much time. So we've come around, you know, Vella with a whole bunch of people on the Vella team, globally included. You know, how we're sort of working with these techniques of this balayage placement along with these chunkier pieces. And the reason we've come to that is, I think, like you said, in the lockdown, we were not getting anything done. Now we want a lot. We want it to be seen.
Yeah.
We want the streaks to be chunkier. We want the placement to be a little more, visible. Yes.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily the choice of colors, but it's the placement that's, So that's where we've ended up with this sort of trend.
But that's actually a really smart way to look at it. Because, I mean, you're giving a trend, which seems rather, you know, something you don't tend to focus on in a time like this, but it's also derived from that, which I think is a great way to sort of merge everything that's going on into a fab look, I would say.
Absolutely. And more importantly, with this particular one, when we're combining that slightly painted balayage technique with the streaks, we are doing this taking into account the person sitting in our chair.
Yeah.
So we are placing it more in, you know, like directly in context to you, that person sitting in our chair. We're fashioning it so that we make it more for the person sitting in our chair. And we do have the option of changing it around. So like you say, the money piece is very popular right now. You know, the one that's smack in the front.
Chunky,
The chunky big, you know what I'm saying? Focus. You can do just that. It's part of the illuminage collection. You could just, you know, like a lot of it can just be what we call the face framing. Less time, more, like I said, it's we've come about, we form you, sort of we fashion it to suit you, the person sitting in our chair, right?
So balayage obviously is one of the most popular, I feel, techniques that we've seen in our country, because everybody from your actors, influence, we're not a country that does too much varied unless you see certain pockets. So balayage, I feel, is something that's working really well, which I think is what the Illuminage collection is about. But you mentioned it's a collection, so can you take me through a couple of more looks that you've designed for it?
So it's like I said, it's this combination of how heavy-handed you want to be in the placement, you know, and it's always got this very displaced color at the end, you know, at the inside and at the bottom, okay. But what we can do with Illuminage is we can, it's not limited to, very, very screaming colors, very, very loud colors. It can be done with soft browns, and it can be done with, the fade going from subtler into slightly brighter, even in the browns or even in the mahoganies. So that's part of the collection. Whereas the other one, one of the other parts of the looks is the more, I love to say this, more vibrant, more like, more noticeable, more in your face, where we are using definitely brighter, more vibrant, like you said, visible colors. So it's about the approach to it. It's the general feel is
a technique, chunkier. Essentially.
Yes, it's generally chunkier, going into a more displaced feeling. But how and what the choice of colors, the combination, the subtler going into the brighter, the root. I don't know whether you know of these words. It's called the root shadow. The root shadow is very big. It gives people a lot more opportunity, between one sitting and the next, the frequency which they would need to come back, because it's this very displaced placement.
So maintenance is fairly, I would say, easier.
Easier. It's not, like how when we used to do them started from the start.
Yeah, and then immediately you can
get the regrowth.
It's something you avoid.
This gives you less of that. Yes, you don't see the regrowth as quickly.
So obviously the growth is one aspect that you've taken care of. But another thing which people are very concerned about, especially first timers, is bleaching your hair. Yes. And when I was reading up about Illuminati, one very interesting thing was that there's also a no bleach balayage.
Yes.
Can you tell me a little more about that? And one more important part, if you could focus on, is how does the color pick up on our dark pigmented Indian hair?
Well, it's formulated to do that. We don't have to use bleach.
Okay.
I would like to discuss bleach a little bit if we have the time and the opportunity. And that bleach is not scary. But we're right now talking about the no bleach balayage, right?
Surprisingly, that's what I'm saying. Surprisingly, I'm of the same school of thought as you. But the most common question we get about anybody who ever comes in to talk about colors, but is the bleach going to damage your hair?
We'll delve into in a minute. But the no bleach balayage is, as you said, people do have a reservation with when we feel the need to use bleach, right? A sound trained hairdresser will know exactly when and when she does need to use bleach. Just don't slap it on.
Yeah,
right. And so if somebody comes in with a virgin hair, or somebody comes in with hair that's outgrown, we do this with the use of colors.
Got it.
We arrive at these results. And like I said, the color is formulated to definitely lift virgin hair. It's going to work. And I mean, a good 70% of the time, I'd like to say, in the salon, we're only working with colors. Yes, we're not using bleach. We're using colors. So the no bleach balayage is going to give you, it's just going to give you a subtler feel. The nature of these colors is to lift only to that level. So on brunette hair, we Indians have a brunette head. Yeah. And on brunette hair, colors have the capacity and the potential and the potency to lift only that many levels.
Yeah.
It can only lift from a dark brown to a medium blonde. Now these are very technical. Yeah. Right,
you won't get like steel gray hair suddenly in one sitting, for sure.
You will never get steel gray hair without the use of bleach, because we have to take the Indian, like I said, brunette hair.
You break it down a little.
You have to break it down. But if they want subtle browns, and they want beautiful mahoganies, and they want reds, and they want those types of palettes, it's fully doable with just colors.
But that does sound like that. It's great, especially for first timers. Just putting something like this out there, even in communication, is good, because it gives you the confidence to go experiment more than anything else.
And I'd love to say this, but color is such a fun element. I've said this for years. We've come to sort of process our hair being our hair.
Yeah.
And we've learned to accept that to a large degree. But yet there is such a marked difference to when you put a new color in your hair. Just how it can make you feel like a changed person to a very large extent.
Yeah.
And you that's not going to come yet.
You feel more confident.
Yes. You feel, like, you feel more fun. Together, you know? Yes. You feel more current. Yes. Yes. So color does do all of that. Definitely. It does change the way you feel about your, you know, external self.
No, makes sense. So particularly what I gather from everything that we spoke about is this entire Illuminage collection is all about customization and a lot of ease of maintenance as well. Keeping that into account, do you have any tips or, you know, word of advice for people who are considering coloring their hair for the first time? Because customizing, like something discovery.
Yes. See, I, you know, this, you know, becomes a very difficult question for me to answer because I do understand the limitations that are going on right now. We have to be sympathetic to it.
Yeah.
But for if a client is going to turn on and, you know, off, you know, this medium, this online medium, expect to get, you know, a color job that's meant to look like it's been designed to suit you. On online, that's never going to happen. So as much as I am sympathetic to the situation and people not being able to come into salons right now, people not being able to necessarily afford the services, the one thing I would like to tell them is, please, delay your, if you can't go in right now for those various reasons, delay it, but go to a trained professional. A trained professional is going to work around your budget as much as she or he can. They're going to try. Like I said, we have ways by which we can do it.
Just so that make what a difference.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, that's what it meant. Like advice for people who are even coming into the salon. Because a lot of people come in with apprehensions. Is it going to work? They'll point at a blonde and be like, ye thoda bright to nahi lagega. I mean, we've all been there. You know?
Yes, of course. That I was asking. This is my field. I'm supposed to understand it. But a lay person isn't supposed to understand
it. Exactly.
He's supposed to, you know what I'm saying? They just think slapping a color on their hair should do the trick. It doesn't do the trick. There is a process. There is an understanding. There is education. Like which if I was to turn on and really explain to you what, you know, like a 30 volume, how many levels of lift a 30 volume will give you on brown hair versus how many levels of lift a 30 volume will give you on medium brown hair, you're never going to understand it.
Never going to, not without the level of
exactly, sure. Which we take years and we're constantly updating our skills.
Yeah.
You know what
we
I'm saying?
Just know how to mix one part of this and then mess up your hair.
But will it deliver?
Yeah.
No, it may not deliver. It may not deliver. It may not be, like I said, it may not be placed to suit you.
Yeah.
For starters.
That's then where you may not even get comes in.
You may not even get the color you want.
Yeah.
Yep.
This brings me to like you've really put me in the mood to color my hair. But before that, before we end the chat on that note, this brings me to the last segment, which is about post color care.
Yes.
What do you sort of recommend to keep your hair healthy? One, in salons, what should we go to the salon to do? And secondly, now that visits are prolonged, what do we do at home to keep the vibrancy especially going?
Yes. So there are so many things. Again, clients think that, you know, I hear this all the time that, you know, why is a red faded? That is the nature of reds, the fade.
Yeah.
Now, on the flip side, a blonde is not going to fade as fast. That is the nature of that color pigment, right? But even what we do in salons, okay, is we're certainly adding like things, I'd like to call it things, okay, the lay people, to make the hair, to keep the the hair in its optimal condition, because if the hair is weakened whilst the process is being done, or if the client is doing it too often, or bleaching their too, of course, these are very, very, I'm trying to make it very generic.
It's all too subjective anyway.
Yes, and it's too technical. So what we are doing is that we are certainly, whilst we're doing the process, we're putting products into that chemical to to maintain the integrity of the hair, to maintain the quality at its optimal. So not only are we doing things like Wellaplex with our colors to maintain the integrity of the hair. The integrity of the hair is in its optimal condition. The color is going to fade less. It doesn't mean that you don't need to go home and do your own bit.
Of course, there's always addition.
Yes, you know, the client needs to do it, do the upkeep and the maintenance and the deep conditionings and the spas and the, you know, the, you need to replace some of the protein, which is in the hairdressing terminology, it's called keratin.
Keratin, yeah.
You need to replace. Now, the keratin is not one of those processes.
Not those treatments. Not like this actual protein.
Yes, in the oils, you know, we can do the keratin-based hair spas. What you do at home is imperative. When you are using heat, if you are so choosing to use heat, most people don't realize the what heat is going to do to your color. Heat is going to change the color. It is going to change the vibrancy of the color. It's going to change the how long the deposition stays on the hair.
And it's the quality itself, changes how the color looks.
Yes, and the quality. So
I'm learning.
And you choose to use heat without thermal protects.
Yeah.
Thermal protectants. You are not treating your hair with the respect you need to do so. If you are choosing to not use the guidance of your stylist, the right shampoo, the right conditioner, the right, because there are a multitude of products available now.
Yeah.
Your sound hairdresser is going to choose the product that will suit your hair, your color, your scalp, your lifestyle. So she is giving you, but again, you know, even in the color range of the shampoos and conditioners, there's the color motion, which works phenomenally well with color products. Right,
which I personally tried and I loved. Oh my!
It's
God.
A Vela super.
Products in general are so gentle but effective.
Yes,
and this one in particular was so good.
Yes, I mean, I'm going to have to say this. The reason I have, and me and my mom have been
a Vela
salon for now at least 23 years, is because I am extremely and have been.
Just fond of the product.
It's delivered. No, it's delivered. Yeah. It's delivered across the board for the last 23 years. I mean, I'm an exclusive Vela salon for Vela. And, you know, my role with Vela as a creative stylist is sort of different. This is a salon. This is, it delivers, the products deliver what I need for them to deliver. So I've been so happy with the brand as a professional. I feel
and personally, I think that adds a lot of value when, like, I feel like when you endorse a product, when you personally also love it, there's that.
I wish I could take you into my shower right now and show you the amount of product.
I wish I could take you in mine because it's the same state. That's Vela.
Yes, there is, and because I'm really, I know that they deliver. One has to understand the right combination with which you're using products. You know, so for us to give the advice, sort of generic advice on whether it be Instagram, social media, is very difficult because, like I said, we're combining a series of products. We're combining a series of spas or spa products, you know, in combination, permutation combination to suit you, your hair, your lifestyle, your scalp, your color, you know, all of the above.
No, it definitely makes sense. And like you said, like, that's where the expertise comes in. That's where those 10, 20 years of experience are going to come in versus a tutorial, which is 2 minutes of explanation and that's about it.
And it's not, there's no personal space. This is somebody that's just gone on there and said.
The same thing, like box colors and everything can only do so much. But like you said, Illuminage is like a whole collection devised by a brand, keeping in mind not just you, but the atmosphere around you, everything. So there's, you know, there are way too many levels that go into
I'm never going to lie. I'm never going to say, you know, you may not arrive at the results you so choose if you put a box color. But there's a very strong likelihood you may not. You may end up with something completely disastrous.
And then you still have to run back to a stylist.
Yes. No, we don't complain, believe you me. I love a color correction. I love a color correction. When I make a lot more money from a color correction, I'll have you know. I make a lot more money.
Yes.
But it also gets me to, you know, work harder because when I'm trying to.
It's a challenge. It's a new sort of a challenge. It's a new.
Which I love. You want to sometimes sit in the salon for 2 hours. For 2 days, sorry. Does the client want to sit in the salon for 2 days if she's, you know, made the botched it up so badly? I mean, this is just perspective.
Got it.
Just food for thought.
It absolutely makes sense. And this was a really fun chat because not only did I kind of now not only am I itching to go back to the salon now, but like I really know what I'm going to go back and do.
Wonderful.
But thanks for taking out time to do this and for taking us through the Vella Illuminage collection.
I'm so glad I could. Thank you for having
chatting.
Me.
And thank for you. All your tips and tricks, I'm sure lots of people are going to benefit
hopefully. From
this. Thank you.
Thank you so much.